questions, you can stop me. Okay. Okay, so this is, these are the outcomes of this topic. Okay. So number one, number two, and number three. Okay, so next. All right. So introduction. So what is a control system? Okay, so how does the control system look like? And what is the example? Okay, in a control system. Okay, so these are the example of control system. For example, car, your car. So in this car, there are many types of control system. Okay, so you can see that types of control system in this car. It can be the steering system, the engine system, the wheel system, and so on. Okay, so and the electronic system, and so in this car there are lots of control system, which is we use in every day. Okay, so other than that is this emulator system. Okay, so we can see this in this system. There must be a controller, must be the actuator, it must be plan, okay, to work this thing. Okay, another example is the water level in a plant. Okay, so we can see that this water is flow from the main supply into the tank. Okay, and we can see that there is a sensor which is used to detect the water level. Okay, so this is the output. Okay, there might be input and there is an output. Okay, the sensor is to detect which level of this water, and it will send the signal into the actuator or virtual machine. Okay, so that this water can be stopped or can be flow again, and so on. Okay, so this is what a control system. So in a control system, we have we need to have the input, output, actuator, controller, okay, and the plant itself. Okay, so basically this is the idea of the control system. Okay, another thing is and everything in our daily life, there is a control system. Okay, including this air conditioning system. Okay, including our body. Okay, for example, our heart, that is a system, flowing system, that control our heartbeat, our muscles, our bone, okay, and digestion system, okay, blood flow system, and so on. Okay, so there is a control system. Okay, so now we take the first example for automobile. Okay, or a car system. Okay, so this is general. Okay, I'm not talking about the machine itself, but the general things, how to function the automobile, okay, the car. First, let's say you have a desired cost of travel. Okay, so let's say you want to start travel your car by using your car. Okay, so this is considered as the input. All right, and next we have a summing point or junction, and the controller. Okay, we have the controller. The controller of this car would be the driver. Okay, next, what makes the car moving? Okay, so it has an actuator. Okay, the actuator in this example is the steering mechanism. The steering will make this car moving. And the third one is the plan. The plan itself is the automobile. Okay, automobile. All right. So From the input or desired cost of travel, which is controlled by the driver, which is moving by the actuator or the steering mechanisms, and the plant is the automobile itself, and it will produce the actual cost of travel. Okay, all right, so this would be considered as the output. All right, so from the output, there is a feedback. Okay, feedback element, or in another case, it's called also as a sensor. Okay, so from this output, it will measure visuals and tactiles, any things in this car to be given into the input. Again, for example, like this car is too speedy. Okay, so the driver need to control so that the car will become much slower. Okay, all right, by controlling the actuator, steering mechanism and so on, and it will keep looping in this control system. So this is what we call as closed loop, because there is a feedback or sensor in this system. Okay, but if you didn't have the feedback or sensor, then it will call as a open loop system. Okay, any questions so far?
Tak ada buat kursus sekarang.
Alright, so faham eh? Okay, next. Alright, so it is same as we are human. Okay. So what is your desire? For example, you have a desire to pass this course in this semester. Okay, so this is your input, your desire. Okay, and then what is your output? You have to wait until the end of semester, whether you need to know whether you have passed or not in this course, for example. Okay. So what is your controller? The controller is you yourself. Okay, you need to control yourself to study, to revise, to attend the class, to do the test and so on. Okay, so what is your actuator? Okay, so your actuator is something that moves you to do. For example, like in this case, like a discussion, okay, ataupun anything lah yang relate to the study, your study. Okay, what is your plan? So in this case, your plan is you attend the class like ODL, okay, ataupun your classroom, your GC, your Google Drive and so on lah. Okay, so what are disturbance? Disturbance ni noise. Contohnya, your laziness, okay, ataupun your sleepy, ataupun your financial problem. So for example, okay, so these are the criteria that you need consider in the control system. Okay, so let's say kalau I bagi, let's say I give you a diagram of a system, so you should know how to identify what is the input, output, controller, actuator, plant or process, and what is the disturbance, what is the sensor and feedback element as well. Okay, all right, so okay, let's see the closed loop control system. Okay, like I mentioned just now, okay, this is a typical closed loop control system block diagram. Okay, so we can see that this is a feed forward path of the closed loop system. We can see first we have an input signal. Okay, this input signal can be from the input transducer or anything. Okay, and then it will go into the summing point, which is it will go straight to the controller. Okay, so block is elements or the things, okay, this arrow is a signal. Okay, dia tak nampak signal. Okay, for example, arrow signal. This is control signal. Maksudnya dekat controller ni, for example, input signal ni, let's say you bagi frequency ataupun you bagi voltage, ya, value of voltage. Voltage current ataupun current ke I. Okay. So input transducer ni is a sensor lah. Okay, which is they detect the input signal. And then dia akan masukkan this signal into the controller. Controller ni akan detect the signal and dia akan bagi output juga kepada actuator and implant, and lastly baru dia bagi output signal. So maksudnya let's say awak nak voltage signal ni fix to 5 volt. 5 volt. Okay, after masuk controller ni apa semua. Okay, ha, contohnya output signal dia hanyalah 3 volt contoh. Maksudnya dia ada difference, ya. Dia ada difference between desired dengan actual, ya. Okay, this signal ya, 3 volt ni, okay, dia akan send to the sensor. Okay, this sensor will send the signal into the summing point when, and then it will produce here as an error. Maksudnya error sini 3 volt, sini 5 volt. Meaning it has minus 2 volt error. So this controller said it has to increase the voltage. Okay, this actuator, for example, the current, the voltage source, it will increase the voltage up to let's say dia naikkan jadi 4 volt pula. Ya. Yeah? 4 volt, and then dia again it send the signal 4 volt here to here. So it have minus 1 volt. Okay, it said it still not reach the desired. So the controller said it have to increase the voltage to 5 volt. Okay, the actuator will keep increase the until 5 volt. Okay, sampailah dekat sini output. The output is here is 5 volt. So, meaning that sama, eh? Actual and desired and actual is the same voltage. So, bila bila dekat sini dia punya error would be 0 volt. So, dia akan maintain lah. It will keep looping, ya. Eh? Keep looping. So, this is what we call as a control system, closed loop control system. Okay? Okay. So, untuk closed loop control system ni, we have a mathematical models. Okay, what is the use of mathematical model? Okay, mathematical model is used to represent in mathematical terms of behavior or real device and objective. Okay, samalah contohnya macam kita belajar linear system. For example, Y is equal to, eh, kita belajar masa sekolah dulu, eh, YT is equal to XT. Maksudnya dia adalah straight line signal, betul? Like this. Yeah? Maksudnya when T is equal to 1, eh, X1 pun akan equal to 1. Eh? For example lah. Okay. Here 1 is 1. So, this is the mathematical model for this case. Sama juga kalau kita ada dia panggil apa ni? Eclipse. So, Y is equal to X square. Ya? Yeah? X square ke? Minus X square ke? Okay? Sama juga macam ni. So, this is the mathematical model for these types of signal. Tapi untuk for example, measurement of the volume of this box, we have y is equal to the height time width time length. Okay, so this is the mathematical model. Sama juga, so this is the model, tapi dia represent dalam bentuk mathematical. Kenapa kita represent dalam bentuk mathematical? Why? Because in mathematical model, it is much easier to represent in mathematics rather than you represent dalam bentuk yang lain yang lebih kompleks. Okay, that's why mathematical model ni dia banyak guna untuk represent any system. Any system, eh? Contohnya sistem, kompleks sistem macam machinery, ya, plant and so on tu semua dia ada dia punya matematik model masing-masing lah. Okay. Okay, so now we see what we have in mathematical model. Okay, first is the transfer function representation. Okay, so this is a way to represent the physical system mathematically. Okay, so it has different types of subsystems such as electrical, mechanical and electromechanical. Okay, so it consists of different types. Yeah. And each system transfer function, yeah, tengok kat sini, each system transfer function can be obtained from the schematic diagram. Okay, maksudnya dalam satu a big system, we can have many subsystem, and each subsystem it has its own transfer function. Okay, for example, yang ni kita tak tahu lah ni function apa, maybe ini function dalam dalam apa? Air conditioning system ke ataupun dalam kereta mechanical apa steering system ke apa, for example like this, eh, we have this one as input and this is the output and this is the mathematical equation dia. Okay, so macam mana kita nak keluarkan dia punya transfer function? Okay, transfer function is defined as the output divide by input. Okay, so meaning that the transfer function of this system is delta OS over EAS equal to 25 over SS plus 1. Okay, so this is the transfer function. Okay, this is a simple, simple system. But what about this this complex ataupun this closed loop system ni, macam mana dia punya transfer function ataupun mathematical modeling? Because we have to consider ni ada input, sini ada output, sini ada input, sini ada output, and kita ada yang general, sini output, sini input dia, sini error dia. Okay, sini ada summing point, positive, negative, amplifier lagi sini semua. Okay, so how do we create its transfer function? How do we develop its transfer function system or mathematical modeling there? Okay, now again, to identify the transfer function of open loop transfer function. Okay, open loop transfer function senang je. Okay, ini adalah open loop. Okay, maksudnya this open loop is CS over ES equal to GS. Okay, alright. So untuk closed loop transfer function, yeah, closed loop transfer function. Okay, so this is contohnya open loop tadi, yeah, open loop, yeah. Okay. Untuk mana closed loop? Okay, so this is the closed loop transfer function. Okay, G, this one is considered as G. The feedback considered sebagai H, and output adalah R, and input adalah C. Summing point here is positive, and here is negative. So for closed loop transfer function, so this is fixed, yeah, this equation is fixed. So C over R equal to G S over 1 plus G S H S. Okay, so closed loop transfer function in this case is C S over R S equal to apa tadi, GS, yeah, GS 1 plus GS HS. Okay, so yang ni, yeah, kita punya closed loop control system. Okay. Okay, for example, given in the question is G is equal to 1 over s plus 2, and hs is equal to s. So what is the open loop transfer function? Okay, open loop transfer function would be
open loop equal to
this. Okay, macam ni, eh? Open loop is B over E G time H. Yeah, G time H. Open loop. E dekat mana? E is kat sini, eh? Arrow. Arrow ada sini. This is E here. Okay. Sama lah. Kat sini, B. Kat mana B? B kat sini. Kat sini, eh? C. C dengan ni samalah. Eh? C dengan B sama. Okay, sorry. B, E. Oh, sorry. B di sini. B di sini. Okay. So, B over E equal to G time H. Okay. So, untuk open loop transfer function, B over E G time dengan H, HS. Okay, so masukkan G yang ni, H adalah yang ni. Okay, so untuk open loop transfer function, 1 over S, S plus 2 timeskan dengan S. So, ni jawapan dia. Okay, so this is the open loop transfer function. Kalau untuk closed loop transfer function, gantikan je 1 over S, S plus 2 over 1 plus 1 over. Okay, so saya rasa awak boleh solve, eh? Masukkan je lah G dengan this one, H dengan this one. Okay, boleh, eh?
Boleh, boleh.
Okay, you try solve yourself. Okay, so other than that, we have a ratio. Ratio ni, error ni. Error. Okay, error is R minus B patutnya. Okay. Error is R minus B. Okay, B adalah dekat sini. Output dia. Okay, ni tak apalah, nanti kita tengok, eh. Nanti kita tengok macam mana untuk reduce block diagram tu. Okay. Okay, system response pula. Okay, system response. Okay. Output response of a system is the sum of two response. Pertama is force response. So, it produced due to the external input, and natural response produced due to internal input of the system. Okay. Respon ni maksudnya output lah, output. Okay. So, kita bagi input pada satu sistem, and then kita nak tengok apa output dia, respon. Dia respon dia kat sini, output. Okay. So, adakah bila kita bagi signal macam ni, so, what happened to the response? Adakah dia akan jadi besar? And so on. Okay. So, it has two response, eh? Force response or natural response. Natural response ni macam dia punya apa tu? It include itself in the signal. Okay. So, dia memang dah ada dalam signal tu. Kalau force response ni, dia adalah disebabkan oleh external input. Okay. Okay, poles and zero. Okay. This one, I think you have learned in linear system. Linear system, poles and zero. Okay. Poles of a transfer function, a Laplace transform variable S that cause the transfer function to become infinity. Okay, 0 is the transfer function. Laplace transform variable S that cause the transfer function to become 0. Maksudnya, kita ada transfer function. Tadi saya kata, output is CS, input is R kan? Okay. Alright. So, kita ada let's say S plus 1 over S plus 2. And S. Example lah, ini adalah transfer function system kita. Okay. So, yang belah atas ni, the denominator is poles. Okay. Yang bawah ni adalah zeros. Okay. So, apa maksud dia ni? Okay. Maksudnya yang S ni, sini ada satu S, sini ada dua S. Maksudnya yang atas ni dia ada satu poles, yang bawah, sorry saya silap ya, saya silap. Atas adalah zero, bawah adalah poles. Okay. So, what is the function of the poles? Okay. This poles will make the transfer function will become infinity. Okay. Dalam Laplace transform, untuk find stability, saya rasa awak dah belajar dulu. Okay. We have S plane. Okay. Complex S plane. Betul tak? Okay. So, yang ni adalah okay, tak muat lah pula. Okay. Contohnya macam ni. Nampak ke yang saya tulis ni? Nampak ke?
Nampak.
Okay. Nampak. Kita ada S-plane. S-plane. Kita ada yang X, axis ni adalah real. Yeah? Real. And this is imaginary. Okay. Real imaginary ni macam 2 plus J2. This is real, this is imaginary kan? Sama juga. Okay, so yang ni dia boleh tukar kepada bentuk S ni. Bentuk S. So that's why lah dalam masa masa awak belajar dulu dalam Laplace transform, kita tukar daripada T kepada S. T kepada S. Okay, for example, this is S plus 1. Okay, so it's actually the zero S equal to minus 1. Tapi yang ni saya rasa nantilah kita tengok. Takut awak pula tak faham nanti. Okay, so kita tengok kalau poles, ya. Yeah? Poles kita denote as sebagai X and zeros kita denote sebagai kosong lah. Okay, kalau dalam S plane tu, kita ada poles lie on the right hand side. So, the system will become unstable. Ingat tak? Kalau zeros, dia tak kisah. Zeros sebelah kiri boles, sebelah kanan boleh. Tapi kalau poles ni, dia lie on the right side of the S plane, the system will become unstable. Ingat balik tu. Okay. This is the example. Okay. So, this is the transfer function of the system. Okay. So, we have here is S plus 2 and the zeros. This is the zeros and this is the poles. Okay, meaning that we have zeros dia, S is equal to minus 2. Yang dekat bawah ni, poles kita ada dua. Iaitu S sama juga dengan kosong dan juga S sama juga dengan negatif 5. Okay, so kalau kita plot dalam apa nama ni, dalam S-plane ni, okay, S equal to kosong ni, this is actually input, okay, input sebagai input, okay, takpelah ni, okay, so kalau kita plot, negative 2 is dekat sini lah, negative 2, sini 1, 2, 3, sini negative 1, negative 2, negative 2, negative 5, okay, so, dia akan berada di real, eh, real. Real punya apa nama axis ni. Okay, real axis. Okay, kalau example, kalau awak ada S square plus 3S plus 2. Okay, yang ni dia akan jadi complex lah. Tengok kalau kita boleh find dia punya roots, dia akan jadi apa nama, inilah, dia takkan jadi complex, ya, kecuali kalau dia ni. Okey, boleh tengok dekat sini ni contohnya. Force of input, ada soalan tak ni? Saya takut saya cakap seorang-seorang je lagi. So yang ni kita akan tengok, ya. Kita akan tengok nanti dalam dalam topik ni juga. Okay, macam mana awak nak plot the display, macam mana awak nak calculate ni semua-semua ni. Okay, ya.
Okay, okay.
Contohnya ni. This is output time response. Okay. So macam mana kita convert kepada bentuk S. Kalau ingat table Laplace transform tu. Okay, kalau dululah, Laplace transform, saya tak tahulah awak ingat ke tak. Okay, kalau kita ada UT, kita convert dia akan jadi 1 over S, tak salah saya. Ya, kalau RT dia akan jadi 1 over S square. Ingat tak? Kalau exponential alpha t, dia akan jadi apa, tak ingat dah. Dia akan jadi macam ni. 1 over S plus alpha. Dia ada Laplace transform table tu. Okay. Okay, so kita tengok. Okay, so dalam kita punya top subject, ya, this semester, for this chapter, so saya akan tengok kepada second order system sahaja. Okay, second order. Second order tu maksudnya S square ke atas lah. S square plus AS plus B. Okay, this is the second order. Okay, kalau just S plus A, this is first order sahajalah, eh. Okay, so kita akan tengok the second order system, dia punya step response and so on semualah. Okay, so for example, saya ada satu sistem macam ni. So yang ni GS, ya, GS, di mana GS adalah equal to, okay, B over S square plus AS plus B. Okay, so input dia adalah R, output dia adalah C. Okay, so let's say kita tengok pada over them. Response will be over them. Okay, over them kalau both poles lie on the left, dan dia adalah real, real. Okay, so yang ni adalah plotted in MATLAB ni, saya rasa. Okay, so sistem over them ni macam mana bentuk dia adalah macam ni, di mana dia punya apa ni, lambda ni is less than one. Okay, so bentuk dia macam ni. Okay, kalau under them, so nampak dia akan ada overshoot dan dia punya pose ni akan berada pada complex. Nampak dia punya ni, dia akan berada di complex. Maksudnya dekat sini adalah minus 1 plus minus j to the square root of 8. Okay. Yang ni over them ni dia ada dua roots, locus. Ya. Maksudnya s plus 7.85 ni, and then s plus 1.146. Okay. So dia ada dua. Okay. So yang ni dia punya lambda in between 0 and 1. So nampak dia punya respon ni macam mana. Okay. Undamped. Okay. Undamped ni kita akan nampak dia punya pos berada di atas line ataupun atas axis imaginary. And the response will become like this. Nampak tak dia oscillate? Okay, kalau macam ni, kalau macam ni, dia naik saja sampai satu. Kita sebenarnya, okay, step response, kita masukkan input. Okay, kita masukkan input dia step. For example, saya inject voltage source ataupun any signal, let's say a step from zero, dia akan step to any point lah, here. Let's say any point lah, let's say kat sini adalah satu. Satu. From zero, saya nak dia step kan jadi satu. Input. Ya, yeah, input. So, output dia, output dia ni lah, sama ada over them, ataupun under them, ataupun undamped or critically damped. So, bila nampak tak, saya punya desire ataupun saya punya input pada masa t equal to zero, saya nak terus input dia become one secepat yang mungkin. Daripada zero, zoom naik one kan. Tapi bila saya letakkan di sistem, what happen? For example, over them ni, dia slowly increase sampai kat sini. Okay, sampai ke berapa ni baru nak naik sampai satu. Okay, sampai ke lima baru nak sampai satu. Ni pun maybe tak sampai satu, maybe setakat 0.9 sahaja. And then dia maintain. Okay, this is what we call over them. Okay, so next under them. Okay, and sama juga. From zero, dia terus overshoot kepada more than one. More than one, nampak tak? And then dia drop balik and then dia oscillate. Sampailah dia maintain ke satu ni. Okay, maksudnya saya nak tunggu dia stable tu a bit lama. Sampai T equal to 5 baru dia stable 1. Okay. Okay, for undamped pula, so nampak dia terus overshoot ke 2 and then dia turun balik ke 0 and then dia keep oscillate. Dan saya tak tahu sampai bila dia nak oscillate. Which is undamped ni tak boleh. Yeah? For example, kalau you have to control a big tank dalam industri, suddenly it keep increasing sampai 2, and what happen? It will cause something, it will damage and so on. Okay, so kita tak nak sistem tu berlaku. Okay, apa yang kita nak, yang the best is under them, which is kita perlukan overshoot. Kita perlukan overshoot supaya sistem tu lebih cepat, lebih cepat dia naik. Kalau macam ni dia tak ada overshoot, dia akan very slow, nampak? Okay. So lastly, critically damped. Critically damped ni nampak dia dekat sini ada dua post kat sini. Okay, yang ni pun dia lebih kurang sama macam overdamped lah. Okay. Dia naik lambat, dia tak ada overshoot. Tapi the better is this one, underdamped. Okay. So kita nak design kita punya sistem would lebih kurang under them. Sebab kalau kita nak dapatkan input yang ideal macam ni, memang takkan ada lah. Okay. Okay. So, second order under them response specification. So, kita tengok in details dalam under them response ni macam mana. Okay. So, kita boleh represent, we can represent tadi dia punya transfer function. C over R, yang ni adalah GS tadi kan. Okay, GS ni kita boleh represent dalam bentuk ni. Dalam bentuk omega n square plus s square 2 zeta omega n plus omega n. Okay, what we can see from the second order under them response specification. Okay, nampak tadi saya kata, kita ada overshoot which is called as C maximum ni. Point of the overshoot. Pada masa overshoot ni maximum at the peak, so we have the TP. This is semua time, axis ni adalah semua time. So yang ni adalah dipanggil peak time, peak time untuk overshoot. Okay, next is the rise time. Rise time ni maksudnya masa yang diambil untuk rise from zero until berapa? 0.9. Maksudnya 90% of the C final. C final is here. Tadi macam saya kata, kita punya desire Kita nak kita punya input tadi is become one kan, at one. Contohlah one. Okay, one. Okay, so nampak dia akan maintain dekat sini. So sini adalah settling time. Pada masa dia settle. Settle untuk naik dan dia nak maintain. Okay, settle. Settling time. Okay, so this TP. So ini dia punya formula lah. Yang ni tak ada cara, awak kena hafal. Okay. This is omega n. Omega n ni adalah dia punya natural frequency. Yang ni adalah apa tu, damping ratio. Okay, zeta is the damping ratio. Okay. Okay, so it has two different criteria. Sama ada 2% or 5% criteria settling time ni. Okay, yang ni ditetapkan lah. Okay, so kalau 2% you have to use 4, kalau 5, 3. Okay, kalau tak bagi tahu, you can use 2 lah, yang 2 ni. So, percentage of overshoot. Ni overshoot ni, saya kata tadi, overshoot ni, dia overshoot naik sampai atas. Betul. Okay, so this is the formula. This is the formula of damping ratio. Okay, ada soalan? Everyone, ada soalan?
Setakat ni tak ada, cuma masuk-masukkan nilai lah.
Yes, masukkan nilai. So maybe dalam final nanti, sama ada dia suruh awak sketch ni, explain balik, bla bla bla, ataupun dia bagi soalan, dia kata cari dia punya apa nama, settling time ke, dia punya apa, peak time ke. Kalau dia bagi soalan ni, dia punya apa tu, percentage of overshoot is 20%, contohlah ya. Contoh. So, awak kena masukkan dalam formula sahajalah. Cari what is the damping ratio, dia punya apa tu, natural frequency, peak time and so on. Okay. So, this is just guna apply the formula sahajalah, and you have to know how to do it lah. Okay. For example. Okay. Pole plot for an underdamped second order system. Contoh kan. Compute. Now, this will compute the settling time, the TP ataupun peak time, and also percentage of overshoot. So given that the apa nama ni, desired poles is minus 3 plus J5. Okay, maksudnya dia suruh cari TS, TP and percentage of overshoot. Okay, so you have just to guna formula sahaja ya. TS tadi is you just ambil 4 over zeta tadi, zeta omega n. Okay, and then TP is TP is pi over 1 plus apa tadi, omega n minus omega n ya, 1 plus lambda squared. Okay. SD ni adalah minus 3 plus J5. Okay. Ni dekat sini. Minus 3 plus J5. Okay. Maksudnya kat sini minus 3 minus J5. Sini minus J5. Sini kan J. Exist a J. Sini adalah positif J5. So, macam mana awak nak cari apa nama, TS, TP and percentage of overshoot. Percentage of overshoot pun pakai formula juga. Okay, so you have to find what is the zeta, what is the apa nama, zeta is yang ni. Okay, yang ni maksudnya awak kena cari macam mana tu? Kena cari apa ni? This is 3. 3 kan?
Yeah.
3. This is 5. So pakai apa? Pakai ni je lah. Pakai apa tu? Apa tu? Tangent ni lah. Tangent. Pakai apa tu? Apa nama Pythagoras tu? Okay? Boleh kan? ataupun data sama juga dekat sini sudut. Okay, you can find here. So this is tangent theta 5 over 3. Tak salah saya kan? Okay, boleh cuba kan? So dapat sini, you can dapatlah, dapat the value theta ni. So daripada theta ni you can find apa nama, apa lagi eh? You can find the omega n. Eh? Omega n. Okay? Boleh ke? Eh, boleh ke?
Boleh.
Try dulu buat contoh ni. Ini cuma matematikal saja. Okay. Given a closed loop control system, closed loop transfer function, contohnya find the TP or percentage of our shoot and TS. Okay. So yang ni tadi, kita tengok balik pada equation yang ni. Omega n square. Okay, S square plus omega n square. Okay. Yang ni adalah omega n square. Ini adalah S. Dekat sini adalah apa tadi? Zeta. Apa tadi? 2 zeta omega n S. 2 zeta omega n S. Okay. So nak cari TP tadi. Apa tadi? 4 over zeta omega n.
Okay.
Pakai 2%. Kalau dia tak bagi tahu, pakai 2% sahaja. Okay. So daripada sini kita tahulah omega n square ni is equal to 100. So omega n would be 50, kan? Betul ke 50? Kan ni. Okay, 100 square root of. Okay, dapat berapa tu? Okay, so yeah, I think you can calculate this.
10
ha? 10. Okey, 10. Okey. Next. Okey, next. You dapat omega n. And then, daripada sini, 2 zeta omega n equal to 15. Sama kan? So, you have omega n 10. And then, you boleh dapat z. Zeta. Okay. Zeta is berapa? 15 kali dengan 15 per. Okay. 15 10 times 2. Okay. You will get 15 over 220. 20
Okay.
So you ke boleh masukkanlah dalam formula semua ni. Okay. Nanti you can calculate this by yourself. Boleh eh?
Boleh.
Okay. Okay, itu chapter 1 ni tak susah. Dia cuma banyakkan apa, apply the formula and use the formula and understand a little bit of a basic theory of control system. Okay, it's not that difficult lah. You just hafal the apa the formula lah. Okay, ada juga dalam test sometimes ada juga formula yang diberi ya, yang panjang-panjang tu kan. Okay, now let's see the steady state error. Okay, so apa steady state error? Is the difference between input and output for a prescribed test input ST approaching infinity, commonly represent by this one, ESS ataupun macam ni. Apa maksud error ni? Okay, so tadi just now I said that, okay, kalau let's say you nak set the desired input, step input 5 volt contoh 1 volt. Okay, so you nak output dia pun macam ni, tapi it won't be possible lah sama. It will become like this. Contoh. Okay. Maybe dia boleh jadi kat sini 1 volt. Tapi maksudnya still ada error. Kalau kita compare kan dua ni, Dia still ada error. Okay. Error. Contohnya, kat sini, kita ambil 1 volt, tapi kat sini dia, dia macam tu. Okay. So, this is the error. Okay. Dia ada gap sini. So, maksudnya dia ada error. Okay. So, maksudnya ni lah bila T dia approaching, sampailah infinity, dia ada error. Dia takkan sama. Maksudnya input yang masuk is not going to be the same as the input, ya. Output dia will be the same. So that is the steady state error. Okay. For example, okay. So we have three types of input. We have a unit step, or represent by, this is UT ni, UT ni. And then we have a ramp, a step, and then this is ramp, and this is parabolic function. Okay, so this is a UT. Kalau dalam Laplace transform, UT. And this is RT. And this is delta T. Okay, so kalau dalam time function, it's 1. Sebab itulah kalau UT, kita tukar kepada S, dia akan jadi 1 over S. Okay, this is 1 UT. Okay, 1 UT. Belakang ni ada UT. Okay, dia akan jadi 1 over S. Kalau ram is T. T dia akan jadi, this is T UT. Okay, so dia akan jadi 1 S square. And this one is parabolic T square. T square dia akan jadi macam ni. Okay. Now, this is the relationship. Relationship antara input, system type, static error, constant and steady state error. So, in this case, you have to know what is the types of the error. Whether type 0, type 2, type 1 ke. Okay. Alright. So, input kita memang ada 3 sahaja. Unit step, unit ramp or parabolic. Okay. So, this is the steady state error formula. So, for every input ni, dia ada 3 different steady state error. For example, kita kata P tadi, this is the steady state error for step, this is for ramp, and this is for parabolic. So, macam mana you nak identify yang sistem tu adalah dia adalah step ataupun dia ada ramp ke atau parabolic. So that nanti kita tengok contoh, ya. So bila ada steady state error, dia punya KP akan constant. Yang lain akan become zero. Okay. Kalau type 1, KV dia akan constant. Kalau type 0, KP dia constant. Type 1, KV dia constant. And type 2, KA dia constant. Okay, yang ni bila dia ada value, dia ada constant, dia ada value lah. So yang ni become zero, yang ni become infinity, ke infinity. Sama juga yang ni pun. Dia ada value dia. Okay, awak hafal macam ni sahaja. So yang lain, dia akan jadi infinity, zero. Zero, infinity, zero, zero. Okay. Yang penting kena tahu type 1 ke, type 0 ke, type 1 ke, type 2. Okay. Static error constant. Okay, so sama jugalah. Dia punya perbezaan dia cuma di sini ada S, sini ada S square. Okay, GS ni standard lah. Kita ambil daripada kita punya apa tu sistem tadi. Okay. Example. For each systems of the given figure, evaluate the steady state error constant and find the expected error for standard step, ramp and parabolic input. For each system. Okay, first kita tengok yang A ni, ya, yang A ni. Okay, so kita tengok what is the types of the system. Macam mana kita nak tahu types of the system? Okay, kalau macam ni dia tak ada S kat depan. Yang ni ada S. Okay, yang ni ada S square. Yang ni tak ada S. So yang ni adalah type 0. This is type 1. This is type 2. Okay. Awak nampak yang kat depan ni, eh. Ha, maksudnya kat sini dia tak ada. Dia 1 sahaja. Ha, ada 1 sahaja. Ha, yang ni adalah 1 over S kat ni. Sini, ya. Yang ni adalah 1 over S square. So type 0, type 1, type 2. Bila type 0 dia ada apa error dia? 1 over 1 plus KP. Okay, so 1 over 1 plus KP. Yang ni 1 over KV error dia. Yang ni 1 over KA. Alright. So bila dia ada error, so error error. Bila dia ada error, KP dia constant and so on ni semualah. Okay, boleh ya? Ada soalan?
Boleh, boleh.
Okay. Okay, so yang ni lah yang saya cakap tadi. Laplace transform table. Okay, Laplace transform. Okay, so kita convert daripada bentuk T, daripada time domain kepada S domain. Okay, FT ni adalah dia punya function lah. Contohnya macam ni. Daripada apa nama ni, awak ada kelas ke pukul 10 tutorial dengan saya kan? Ya, kita sambung sikit lagi lah ya. Okay, so contohnya kita ada kecoh voltage law. Okay, dia akan ada flow, current flow dalam circuit ni di mana V is equal to I times R times I times L and times C kan. So ni dia punya equation dia dalam bentuk time domain. Dalam bentuk time domain. Okay. So kita boleh convert this equation kepada bentuk S. Bentuk Laplace. Macam mana kita nak tukar? So dia akan become like this. Yang ni memang sepatutnya awak dah tahu lah ni sebab awak dah belajar dalam apa signal and system, linear system. Macam mana nak convert ni hari tu. Okay. Okay, so kalau siapa yang tak tahu ni boleh tanya saya. Sebab saya malas nak ulang balik yang ni. Okay, sebab dia punya ni panjang juga. Okay, saya akan bagi contoh. Kalau tak, yang tak tahu tu tanya. Saya akan bagi contoh macam mana dapatkan kepada T kepada bentuk S ni. Okay. Alright. And then state space. State space ni saya dah masuk chapter 2. Saya rasa nanti kita settlekan dululah yang review ni semua dulu. Baru kita masukkan chapter 2. Okay. Alright. Okay, so now okay, nampak ke?
Nampak.
Nampak eh? Okay. Control system. Okay, so ini adalah sama je macam yang saya cerita tadi. Okay, so this is example of control system. Kita ada water supply. Okay, water supply sini ha. Tak boleh nak edit dah. Okay, kita ada modulating control valve. Yang ni dia punya apa nama, controller. Controller this one. Controller yang ni. Kita punya ni. And then this is the actuator. Actuator ni yang control bagi tahu dekat actuator supaya buka valve. Supaya air boleh lalu lebih banyak. Okay. Capacitance prop ni is dia punya sensor. Sensor ni bagi tahu kat controller yang air is full. So you have to stop the valve. Okay. So controller bagi tahu the valve to stop the valve and close the valve. Okay, so dia akan close. Okay, this is water outlet. Okay, maksudnya bila water supply masuk lebih banyak, so air pun keluarkan lebih banyak. Okay, macam tu. Alright. Okay. Okay, sama juga yang tadi. This is a control system of the antenna. Okay. Azimuth angle, desired azimuth angle. Okay, so ini pun sama jugalah. We have apa nama ni tadi, okay. Transfer function, okay, feedback element, post and zero. Okay. Alright, so this is first order, second order, third order. Bila lebih daripada S kuasa 2, dia akan jadi third order lah. Okay. Okay, so so saya akan bagilah juga apa nama ni. So, okay. Okay, so ini lebih detail lah ya untuk ni given a transfer function example. Okay. Okay, I think that's all. You can go through this slide yang I akan bagi dekat apa nama WhatsApp ya. Okay, boleh ya?
Okay.
Alright. So jangan lupa apa tu fill in your apa nama attendance ya. Alright. Okay, so that's all lah for today. Okay, so this week we will start kita start lagi tutorial. Okay, but if you have any question, you can just ask me. Okay. Alright, everyone.
Okay,
so thank you ya everyone. Assalamualaikum.
Waalaikumsalam.
Waalaikumsalam.
Okay, thank you.